Commissioner, your office is going to introduce a new Europe-wide skills agenda. Can you give me some concrete examples of what this new skills agenda can really deliver?
The agenda will be about educating the skills we need, because the flexibility of the labor market and the economy demands more and more new skills, amended skills or re-educated skills. Only 20-25% of the pupils got competent education in digital skills. We have to make in the future the whole structure of the educational system more flexible.
The expectation is that in 10 years, 90% of the jobs will require some digital skill. There's a lot of things we can do that is actually don't really need money to do it. And this is more to do with a certain message of, do you embrace technology or are you afraid of technology? The discussion on big data is 90% about the threats. It's 90% about what could go wrong. But we are not having the discussion on the benefits. What I would like to have is just a Europe that is forward-looking, a Europe that is not getting lost in fear of technology, but a Europe that says, let's use technology and let's talk about the upside.
When it comes to social media, we have seen that in most of the universities, this is actually a tool that is not being used. And in some cases, even not being used, but also being blocked. The key word here is self-learning. Nobody gave us any kind of tips or any kind of lectures about how to use it. And you have to learn yourself, but when you go to the classroom, I mean, most of the teachers, they don't use it.
I totally understand how some universities might block, actually, social media. When people are just constantly, you know, chatting while they are in lecture, are they really listening? You don't focus on the digital skills as well, only. We can't overlook the human skills as well. You need to have this balance.
The educational establishment is trying to control something it can no longer control. I would say the first skill that we really need people to learn is self-learning. It's about self-discipline. It's about learning how to live in this world and use the tools so they don't end up using you or you don't end up depending. So that's the skill that people need to learn, is to switch off, to know when to go. And that, I think, is where the responsibility of the teachers lies. It's to say, you know, these are tools that are great, but you need to know how to use them. So I would not try to ban them or stop them from using them. I think we have to educate, not protect. I think we have to empower and give learning so they can control it, but not legislate. That's my personal view.